today we gonna discuss about cleavage. As we know that after fertilization there is formation of a zygote, and for the development of the zygote it undergoes several cycles of mitotic divisions without any growth phase. Means G1 and G2 phase are completely absent. M phase, it directly enters into the S phase, and S phase directly enters into the M phase, and so on. Now this series of mitotic divisions are known as cleavage. In case of cleavage, the cell size, it keep on decreasing, whereas the cell number, it keep on increasing. Because no growth phase is present, therefore cell size, it keep on decreasing. As here, we can see that the cell size is much larger as compared to the cell 4 or 2 and so on. This is all because of the cleavage. In case of cleavage, the cytoplasmic volume is same, but the cell size, it has decreased. The resultant cells of the cleavage are known as blastomeres. Now, before going into the types of cleavage, we first must understand about different type of eggs. Now, according to the amount of yolk content, the eggs can be classified as microlecithal eggs or the meso or macrolecithal eggs. Now, microlecithal eggs are those eggs in which the yolk content is very less. Whereas in mesolecithal eggs, the yolk content is moderate. Whereas in macrolecithal, the yolk content is plenty, very large. Now, according to the distribution of yolk content, it can be classified as isolecithal, centrolecithal, telolecithal. Isolecithal eggs are those lecithals in which the yolk content is evenly distributed throughout the egg. Whereas in case of centrolecithal eggs, the yolk content is concentrated towards the center of the egg. Whereas in telolecithal, the yolk content is present at one side of the egg, and that one side of the egg is known as the vegetal pole, whereas the another end is the animal pole. Now, on the basis of the amount and distribution of yolk content, the cleavage can be classified as meroblastic cleavage and holoblastic cleavage. Holo means complete cleavage, whereas meroblastic cleavage is incomplete cleavage. In meroblastic cleavage, because of the presence of large amount of yolk content, because mesolecithal eggs and macrolecithal eggs are mainly involved, so because a large amount of yolk content is there, so the cleavage furrow is unable to penetrate the vegetal pole. Therefore, it is incomplete cleavage. Whereas, no such thing is present in case of holoblastic cleavage, because very less amount of yolk content is there, so the cleavage can occur completely. Now, meroblastic cleavage can be further classified as superficial cleavage or discoidal cleavage. Now, in case of centrolecithal eggs, because yolk content is present at the center, the cleavage occurs at the periphery of the egg. Now, this kind of cleavage is superficial cleavage. It is mainly found in case of insects like Drosophila. Whereas in case of telolecithal eggs, the cleavage is discoidal. Because the large amount of yolk content is present at one side, that is the vegetal side, and the cytoplasmic content, it is situated at the animal pole in a very narrow region, in a disc-like region. So therefore, the cleavage occurs only at the animal pole, and this type of cleavage is discoidal cleavage. It is mainly found in case of fish, reptiles and birds. Now, in case of fishes, reptiles and birds, the eggs that are mainly found are known as the cladoid eggs. In case of reptiles and birds, the eggs are macrolecithal, means large amount of yolk content is present. Now, therefore, these eggs are also known as cladoid eggs or the amniotic eggs, because the yolk content is plenty to provide nourishment to the organism to develop into the miniature of the adult. So, therefore, these are the cladoid eggs. Whereas in case of mesolecithal eggs, the yolk content is moderate. The yolk content is not that sufficient to provide nourishment to the organism. Therefore, the organism first hatches to form a larva, and the larval stage then gets nourishment from the outside environment, which gets converted into the adult form in the later stages of the development. Now coming to the holoplastic cleavage, it is mainly found in case of microlacetal and isolacetal eggs. Now first comes the radial cleavage. In this, the cleavage pattern is perpendicular. Each cleavage is perpendicular to each other and all the blastomeres, they are equal in size. It is mainly found in case of echinoderms and amphioxus. The spiral cleavage, in spiral cleavage, the cleavage pattern is slightly oblique, due to which the upper, the blastomeres which are present at the lower hemisphere, they can rotate either clockwise or anti-clockwise. Those that rotate clockwise are known as the dextral ones, and those anti-clockwise are the sinistral spiral holoblastic. Now the sinistral type is mainly found in case of annelids, and whereas the dextral type, it is found in case of mollusks. Now coming to the bilateral holoblastic cleavage, here the cleavage pattern, one cleavage pattern is followed by all the blastomeres. The first cleavage pattern, it is repeated by the second blastomere and then by the third blastomere and so on. Therefore, the mirror images are formed. It is mainly found in case of tunicates. Then comes the rotational holoblastic cleavage. Here the cleavage pattern is random. It can occur in any plane and it is mainly found in case of mammals and nematodes. Now, this is all about cleavage. You must, for net, CSIR net, you must revise this and learn all the examples with the name of the cleavage, and this mainly comes in the C section in 4-mark question and match the following. So please learn and revise everything for CSIR net. Thank you.